Hello and welcome back to another episode of Your Drone Questions Answered. I'm John Dicko, here to answer your drone questions, or at the very least, find the person who can answer your drone questions. Today, our question is, when it comes to mapping and processing crop and plant health, is a standard RGB camera on a drone sufficient, or do you need an NDVI sensor? There's a little bit more to this question, a little bit more context to provide, and we'll get into that in a second, but I want to introduce our guest who's here to answer this question. That's Matt Donovan. He's the CEO of Agriculture Intelligence, Inc. He's also the Chief Product Officer of AgroView or AgroView.ai. Matt, thanks for joining me.
I'm glad to be here.
So first, let's get to know you a little bit. What do you do at Agriculture Intelligence, Inc., AgroView.ai? Tell me about your businesses and how you use drones.
As you said, I'm the CEO of Agriculture Intelligence and the Chief Product Officer of our flagship cloud-based platform, AgroView. AgroView is an award-winning patented cloud platform dedicated to the perennial tree crop space, invented by Dr. Yanis Ampadzidis at the University of Florida. And I founded the company to bring this technology to market to help perennial tree crop growers like citrus, almonds, apples, avocados, and those kinds of things to help them with inventory counts, per tree health metrics, as well as full field digital leaf-based nutrient analysis. My day-to-day is usually leading the team of software engineers we have, as well as getting direction from our chief science officer, Dr. Ampadzidis, on the overall vision of how we can take raw information or raw data from various sensors, refine that into an actionable piece of information, and then hopefully translate that information into actionable instructions to in-field equipment such as variable rate spray systems.
Okay. So I'm really glad we found you then to answer this question because you sound like you fit the mold perfectly. So let me go ahead. Let me dive into this question a little bit deeper. This was a question that was submitted by a listener or a viewer. His name's Bradley. I'm just going to read it out. In mapping and processing crop and plant health for farmers, an NDVI sensor is the most direct method of capturing the required data. However, in using web ODM, I found there is a model for crop health that is produced from the standard RGB camera on my Mavic Air 2s. Is this post-processing software adequate enough to produce a reliable plant health model for farmers, or will I need to purchase an NDVI sensor and drone just to map crop health?
I probably give the caveat that there's all kinds of new innovations in the sensor space, but generally speaking, an RGB collection can produce indications of crop leaf density and greenness. And it's sort of very dependent on the camera and the conditions of the data collection itself. But typically to do an NDVI, you would need a multispectral collection. That's sort of the simple answer to the question. There can be with a multispectral sensor, the sensor itself, along with the processing system, the ODM engine, for example, it can produce an NDVI, but NDVI is valuable in some respects for certain crops, but it does have limitations. It really wasn't developed for the purposes of what the modern precision agriculture movement really is. It's a fairly old, it's nearly 50 years old, the NDVI standard, if you will. It mostly was developed by NASA to try to help them understand where vegetation was and wasn't. It has been reliable and it's been an indication of some general health of differing crops, but especially in the perennial crop, the tree crop space or the specialty crop space like strawberries or blueberries, things of this nature, it's not quite as precise as what growers, small growers or even commercial growers are looking for when they want to have someone come out, do a data collection, process that information into a visible map, and then apply any type of model to produce a refined informatic that they can use.
Well, and so let's talk about maybe what is the best practice. What would you really need to get good overall mapping and processing of crop health? Maybe you can even talk about what you even use or what you develop.
I guess to answer the specific question to the person who wrote the question, they would need a multispectral, typically a 5-band multispectral sensor. They would need a 5-band sensor that has the RGB, the red, green, blue. They would also need the near infrared band and the red edge. There are sensors that are the 5-band variety on the market, and there's some very popular brands that would provide that. To even attempt to do an NDVI, at least related to the person who asked the question, they would need to buy a 5-band sensor to do a competent representation of an NDVI. Then more broadly speaking, and certainly, you know, not to sort of shill our platform, but the AgroView.ai cloud platform is really trying to take a collection of different data sensors and then assemble that information in a very specific way, and then overlay that with the different models that would be used to produce the kinds of things that the person who wrote the question might be interested in. And for what we do at AgroView, it's to really provide things like the inventory count. In tree crop agriculture, it's important to know, just like any business, how many of these things do I have? If you were running a coffee shop and you didn't know how many coffee cups that you had in your inventory, that would be a real problem when you open the doors and people come streaming in and saying, hey, I need my hot cup of Joe, and you don't have enough cups to serve your customer. Because of the scale of agriculture, really in any space, whether it's annuals like corn and rice, or whether it's in specifically related to tree crops and perennial crops, the inventory of what you have is really important. But drones are a really important step in tackling the scale of these growing operations. Like most people, like even people that are out in the field sometimes don't realize how big a growing operation can be. Even a modest growing operation of 1,000 acres, it might take you 20, 30, or 45 minutes to get to the other side of the acres because of the density of the growing area and the sort of limited space and the conditions of the farm road around the growing space. So drones and other aerial data collections give us a really good opportunity to collect data in mass, which is certainly what this person that's asked the question is talking about. But then it's about what we do with it. You know, the raw data is just raw data. And I think most people that have a drone, they pull the SD card off and they get all these folders that are in numbers. So the AgroView platform looks more towards a way to allow someone who's collecting data or someone who's interested in the result, perhaps like the grower, to utilize a drone surveyor like the Rider and to couple that data collection and then upload that into a system that can assemble it completely, provide rectified orthomosaic picture, and then run models to do something like count the trees or count the gaps where there are no trees, a missing tree model. And then to run another model that evaluates each and every tree, like the AgroView platform itself produces a leaf density index, which is an RGB measurement, but provides, and this is kind of an interesting way to back to the question, a leaf density index can be achieved with an RGB, but you need to have a model that actually understands how to detect that greenness or how to detect that leaf density. We also provide things like the canopy area, as well as the height of each and every single tree that's present. And with the height and the canopy, we can give a general volume calculation inside of our platform. Now, with a multispectral collection, we can take that a step further. And another model that we do for citrus is actually providing a digital leaf nutrient analysis, which typically is again another process that is very challenging because of the vastness of a growing area. And it requires people to go in the field with a bunch of trucks and a bunch of people to go pull leaves off. And this is not soil analysis. This is actually a leaf tissue sample. Pull those tissues off, bag them properly, tag them properly, and then send them off to a lab for analysis to then have some sort of time frame, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 6 weeks, however backed up the lab might be, to then be given a refined informatic or insight into that area. But with a multispectral drone collection or a multispectral data collection, we can examine the entire area. So you might have a 50-acre plot that instead of having, you know, dozens and dozens of samples that have been manually taken and sent to the lab, we can utilize a multispectral data collection, process it into our system, and we can examine all 50 acres. So that 50 acres then can be represented into some standardized management zones that indicate something specific to, for example, like a tree crop grower would be keenly interested in knowing where there's low or deficient levels of nitrogen or phosphorus or potassium, the sort of macros, the protein, fat and carbohydrates of the tree world, that our system actually uses a multispectral data collection to provide a comprehensive full field understanding of that. The AgroView platform is now coming to market to assist those kinds of stakeholders, whether it be growers, crop insurers, other people that are market strategists that are interested in how is the citrus crop of Florida. That's the kind of things that of course, our platform is aimed to serve in the marketplace.
Well, that was actually going to be my next question was, you know, our listeners, our viewers, and a lot of the people that we actually have on the program are sort of people just starting off, whether they've been in the industry for a while and they're just starting to use a drone as a tool, or they've been interested in drones and just starting a business with drones. When it comes to AgroView AI, I mean, is it something that's pretty out of the box, something someone can easily access and kind of start using right away? Or is it something that, you know, requires a little bit of background knowledge and training to understand and really use to its fullest potential?
If someone's asking the question of like, how do I get into flying drones and surveys? Like, that's probably a whole nother podcast. I would succinctly say that data acquisition via drones has differing levels. I would say that in our types of applications, someone that's getting into this business would really need to understand wide scale data collections and then find the drones, which are going to be more expensive, that can provide a better result per mission. So if you want to think about it in acres or square kilometers, the drone starts to get into like some limitations there, but it can be very, very useful. It just depends on the drone that they invest in to buy. As far as how the AgroView AI platform really works, it would be more along the lines of we might want to work with them as a data provider, which we can certainly talk to them about target areas. We would want to enroll them more as a vendor or supplier of our system, which certainly, if you're out there, go to agroview.ai and find my email, by all means, depending on where you are and the crops that we might be able to serve, we would be able to work with them. And then it would be more about them making the data available to us so that then we could go to those crop growers and say, hey, we have a reliable source, a proven source of data acquisition, and we can pair that to give you the kind of results that are going to show you your inventory count, your gap count, your herd tree health, or if they have a multispectral payload, then we could even provide them this very advanced nutrient analysis. Kind of works in most industries that there's a stream of result. The growers that we're working with, the crop insurers that we're working with, or researchers, or perhaps state officials who want to understand the inventory of an area, they might come to us for that. And then we would be able to engage people who are doing the data collection and the data acquisitions as really a partner in that space. So there would be a business opportunity for some enterprising folks that are out there in the drone space. It kind of ranges from like amateur weekend collector, and then to someone who's doing it for work, and then someone who's really doing it as an enterprise. We would probably fit into the second and third tier. And then it would usually be calibrated against, have you ever collected, done data acquisitions for this type of crop? Have you ever been in this type of thing? And then most of the rest of it, as we all know, some of the flight planning softwares and all of that kind of stuff, as long as you start at the right spot and heed the sort of the side lap and overlap and some of the general specifications we would put in place for a surveyor, it can be something that would be an on-ramp towards a potential business opportunity or an opportunity for them to make a little extra money. And then it's about whether the result was good. We have the pilots that we've engaged. We typically have our own specifications. They do some test flights. We look at the data, the result. It usually improves once you've done it a few times, a little muscle memory. If the drone does a lot of the work these days, and if you configure, have the right drones to do these kinds of flights, it can be something that can be scaled up pretty well. If you're in the Southeast, if you're in California, if you're in Texas or Arizona, and you're anywhere near citrus, I definitely would want to talk to you.
Awesome. Awesome. I mean, we're running short on time here, but I want to just throw one more question out there because you mentioned drones and there are certain specifications that are needed when it comes to the drone. What would kind of be the type of drone you would need in terms of baseline specifications? Or is it possible to retrofit a drone with the needed sensors? Are a lot of these drones coming with the sensors already that you would need?
We've seen everything from the DJI quadcopter to the Wingtra fixed wing. And then the payloads are like what can fit on it. In the U.S., with the drone ban and some other things, there's a select list of U.S. drones. They typically, the advantage of it is they usually are a longer range drone. the disadvantages, they're usually more pricey. I would probably defer a little bit as far as what we could use. It more comes down to the result of the survey itself. If we have someone who has a, I would say, above weekend enthusiast drone, DJIs, the quadcopter varieties, we're not a drone company. So I'd caveat that. I would say it would, for us in any kind of commercial endeavor, you kind of need a drone that has some of those capabilities, just because if they're trying to make a business of it, the smaller drones, the sort of the enthusiast drones, they're never going to have the scaled capacity for collection. We're kind of agnostic. If our grower has their own drone and if it's good enough and they're doing their own data, you can upload your own data if you like. If you don't want to do that, then we want to go find the people who can. And drones are going to kind of range dependent upon the payload. It really for us is about the result itself.
I appreciate that. I do just want to give you an opportunity to provide any final thoughts going back to this question of using the right sensor, or even if just a piece of advice for somebody who is interested in kind of getting this and might be new to using this type of technology for this type of purpose within agriculture.
We need to talk to growers and crop insurers and people that want to know about these tree markets. Our system is able to produce scaled, very precise information about the inventories, as I've mentioned, and about the health of these areas. And then it's really about growing the ecosystem of quality data surveyors that would be using drones to do this. It is a growing field. Those opportunities, they're kind of emerging, but they're somewhat clear. Like, there's people that want to be out flying and they don't want anything to do with the stitching. They don't want anything. Kind of goes back to the question is,
sure,
your questioner sort of was at least taking that next step. But there's all kinds, and it's a growing space for everybody. And more importantly, I think overall, we talk about reducing carbon a lot. Like, that's probably the other, as a closing thought, is in a lot of these spaces, the only way to try to get a tree count has been a manual count. It's been a couple of guys or gals in a truck with clickers going up and down, kind of doing their own survey and then keeping tabs on a clipboard. There's been advancements to that, but we're still talking about having more trucks out in the field. And any way we can take a step back and say, hey, you know what? We can do this much faster, much more effectively, even more accurately. And all we had to do is be on the side of the field, you know, put a drone up, collect that information, no more need to put an additional fuel burning vehicle out there for the purposes of doing something that we now can do through another. We push for that as a core part of what we are as a company, is to be a clean technology, but an actual realistic impact. Like, we can't solve the world's problems. Like, our company is at least realistic about with what we do as a company and with suppliers that are competent, you know, data collectors and surveyors. This is an achievable goal in this space, and every little bit helps.
It's a really cool innovation, and I'm really so glad that we had you on here on this program. I feel like we could talk through, you know, two or three more episodes if we wanted to, and maybe we will, because we do get a lot of questions when it comes to the agriculture space and the mapping space itself. Thanks again, Matt Donovan. He is the CEO of Agriculture Intelligence, Inc., the Chief Product Officer of AgroView.ai. Check out AgroView.ai if you're interested in this kind of topic, if you're interested in this kind of question. I think there's a lot to discover there. And you can submit your own questions that we will find the answer to here on Your Drone Questions Answered. You can submit those questions on ydqa.io. Or if you're a part of the Drone Launch Connect community, which is Drone Launch Academy's private community, feel free to shoot us a message over there too. We'd be more than happy to take your question and find the answer to it. In the meantime, we'll see you in the sky.